Namah Shivaya students, this is Pamela ma'am and today I am going to discuss about electromagnetic radiation. As the research went on, when the scientists were trying to give a perfect model for atoms, then results of interaction of radiations with matter provided immense information regarding the structure of atoms and molecules. Niels Bohr utilized these results to improve upon the model proposed by Rutherford. And the two developments played a major role in the formulation of Bohr's model of atom. These were dual character of the electromagnetic radiation, which means that radiations possess both wave-like and particle-like properties. And experimental results regarding atomic spectra, which can be explained only by assuming quantized electronic energy level in atoms. This part, quantized electronic energy levels in atoms, we will discuss later. So today we will discuss about electromagnetic radiation and dual character of the electromagnetic radiation, which means electromagnetic radiations has both wave-like and particle-like properties. And when these electromagnetic radiations interact with matter, immense information, many information about the structure of atoms and molecules were provided. Wave nature of electromagnetic radiation. In early days, light was supposed to be made up of corpuscles or particles, but in 19th century, wave nature of light was established by James Maxwell. Maxwell said that light waves are associated with oscillating electric and magnetic characters. So, James Maxwell, he suggested that when a electrically charged particle moves under acceleration, alternating electrical and magnetic fields are produced and transmitted. These fields are transmitted in the forms of waves called electromagnetic waves or electromagnetic radiations. This is the diagram for electromagnetic radiations. An electromagnetic wave or electromagnetic radiations consists of two components. One is electrical component, electric field, and another is magnetic. The oscillating electric and magnetic fields produced by oscillating charged particles are perpendicular. So these two fields, these blue fields are electric field and these pink fields are magnetic fields. And if we see that these two fields are perpendicular to each other and both are perpendicular to the direction of the propagation of the wave. So electromagnetic radiation has two components. One is electric and another is magnetic, and these two, electric field and magnetic field, they are perpendicular to each other, and both these fields are perpendicular to the direction of the propagation. So in this diagram we can see that this is the direction of propagation. So these two fields are perpendicular to each other and also perpendicular to the direction of propagation. Now, characteristics of waves. Just like waves, electromagnetic radiation tells about wave motion. What is wave motion? If we throw a stone in a pond, then wave forms. Now, what are the characteristics of waves? So, first characteristic, that is wavelength. What is wavelength or lambda? It is the shortest distance between equivalent points on a continuous wave. Measured from crest to crest. What is crest? This is the crest, upper part of the wave. And down part or downwards direction of the wave is known as trough. So upper part, that is known as crest, and down part, that is trough. So measured from crest to crest or trough to trough is known as wavelength. So the distance, shortest distance between two crest, this is one crest and this is another crest. So the distance between two crest is known as wavelength, or distance between two troughs. These are two troughs, so shortest distance between two troughs is also known as wavelength. And what is the unit? It can be measured in meter, centimeter or nanometers. And what is frequency or nu? The number of waves that pass a given point per second, expressed in hertz. Or we can also say that number of cycles a wave takes in 1 second. So this is the cycle, one cycle, starting from the origin, then one crest and one trough. This is one wave. So number of cycles, wave cycles or wave cycles of wave takes in 1 second, that is known as frequency. And it is expressed in hertz or second inverse. And amplitude. What is amplitude? Wave's height from the origin to a crest or origin to a trough. So this is the origin. So the height of the crest or height of the trough is known as the amplitude. Now, nature of electromagnetic waves. Unlike sound or water waves, electromagnetic waves do not require medium to propagate. That means they are transverse waves without a medium. They can travel through empty space. They travel as vibrations in electrical and magnetic fields, and have some magnetic and some electrical properties to them. And the speed of electromagnetic waves is that equal to 10 to the power 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. That means it has the speed of light. Then wave nature of electromagnetic wave. Now, there are many types of electromagnetic radiations which differ from one another in wavelength or frequency. These constitute electromagnetic spectrum. Different regions of spectrum are identified by different names, like radio frequency region, radio frequency region, which is 10 to the power 6 hertz. Then microwave, this is radio frequency region, microwave region, infrared region, UV region. This is visible region, X-ray region, and gamma regions. Now, visible region, this part, visible region. In this part, our eyes only can see, and rest are non-visible radiations. These gamma rays, X-rays, infrared, UV, microwave, radio frequency, we cannot see. So, special instruments are required to detect non-visible radiation. Now, different kinds of units are used to represent electromagnetic radiation. The radiations are characterized by the properties, namely frequency, nu, and wavelength lambda. So we can see that this is the electromagnetic radiation, different type of electromagnetic radiation which constitute electromagnetic spectrum. Now this is the frequency or nu, and it is given in second inverse, and this is the wavelength. Now we can see that 10 to the power 12 to 10 to the power 10. This part is radio frequency. Then microwave, 10 to the power 8 to 10 to the power 6. Then 10 to the power 6 to 10 to the power 4, this is infrared, and then ultraviolet, then X-ray, and then gamma rays. Now, in between ultraviolet and infrared, visible region comes in the range of 400 nanometer to 750 nanometer. The nature of light. As I have already discussed that electromagnetic radiations has two nature, that is, one is particle nature and another is wave nature. Before the beginning of the 19th century, light was considered to be a stream of particles. The particles were either emitted by the object being viewed or emanated from the eyes of the viewer. And Newton was the chief architect of the particle theory of light. Nature of light, alternative view. Christian Huygens argued that light might be some sort of a wave motion. Then another scientist in 1801, Thomas Young, provided the first clear demonstration of the wave nature of light. He showed that light rays interfere with each other. This phenomena is known as interference, and this phenomena can only be explained by the wave nature of light, and such behavior could not be explained by particle nature of light. Then more confirmation of wave nature. During the 19th century, other developments led to the general acceptance of the wave theory of light, and Maxwell asserted that light was a form of high frequency electromagnetic wave. Then, dual nature of light. In view of these developments, light must be regarded as having a dual nature. Dual nature means a wave nature and also a particle nature. Now, as light has wave nature, since light travels at a very high speed, early attempts to measure its speed were unsuccessful. But later, the speed it was measured that 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Now, particle nature of electromagnetic radiations. Some phenomena like diffraction and interference explained with the help of wave nature of light. And some phenomena like black body radiations and photoelectric effect only could be explained by particle nature of the radiation. Wave nature can't explain these two properties. Now, what is a black body? In 1900, Max Planck explained the phenomenon of black body. Black body, when solids are heated, they emit radiations over a wide range of wavelength. For example, an iron ball, when heated, first it becomes dull red, then progressively it becomes more and more red, then it becomes white and then blue. And when temperature is very high, it gives a blue radiation. In terms of frequency, we can say that frequency of emitted radiation goes from a lower frequency to a higher frequency as the temperature increases, because red color lies in the lower frequency region while blue color belongs to the higher frequency region of the electromagnetic spectrum. And a black body is a perfect absorber and a perfect radiator. That means a black body absorbs all radiation falling on it at all wavelength, and it radiates all the radiations. So it is a perfect absorber and a perfect radiator. This is a black body radiation. So a matter, suppose a radiation is allowed to enter through a small slit. So this radiation enters and then reflects, and again it reflects here, and again it reflects. This way it reflects inside this body, but it never allowed to become out. So this is a black body. When matter is heated, it emits radiation. And a black body is a cavity in a material that only emits thermal radiation. Incoming radiation is absorbed in the cavity. As I have already discussed, that radiation emitted by a heated object, black body radiation emitted by a heated object. When not heated, the object is black, and when heated, the object varies in color depending on the temperature, and it gives a continuous spectrum. A black body absorbs and emits all the radiations of different wavelength. And cooler object means less radiation, and hotter object means more radiations. Now, the exact frequency distribution of the emitted radiations, that is intensity versus frequency curve from a black body, depends only on temperature. So, if we plot the intensity versus wavelength graph of the black body radiations, it depends only on the temperature. At a given temperature, intensity of radiation emitted increases with decreased wavelength. So we can see the intensity increases with decreased wavelength, because wavelength decreases this side, because wavelength is here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this side shorter wavelength and intensity increases this side. So intensity at a given temperature, say for this is 4000 Kelvin, at a given temperature intensity increases with decrease in wavelength, then reaches a maximum and then starts decreasing with further decrease of wavelength. Here also reaches a maximum, then start decreasing. Here also reaches a maximum, then starts decreasing. The black body experiment cannot be explained satisfactorily on the basis of wave theory of light. Planck suggested that atoms and molecules could emit or absorb energy only discrete quantities and not in a continuous manner. And that's why he gave the name quantum. What is quantum? It is the smallest quantity of energy that can be emitted or absorbed in the form of electromagnetic radiation. Now, the second phenomena that can be explained with the particle nature of the electromagnetic radiations only. And what is photoelectric effect, and what is it? It is the phenomenon of ejection of electrons when a light of suitable frequency falls on metal surface. So in this diagram we can see that a metal surface, it is taken in a vacuum chamber and connected to the battery, and in other side we have taken a detector. And if a radiation of suitable frequency falls on it, then electrons are ejected, and this phenomena is known as photoelectric effect. Now, some important terms related to photoelectric effect is threshold frequency. Now, threshold frequency, it is the minimum frequency of a photon that will cause an electron to be emitted from the material. That means a minimum frequency is required to release electrons, and this minimum frequency is known as threshold frequency. This is the graph for threshold frequency. When electron ejects, it will move and gains kinetic energy. more the frequency, more electrons will be released and more the electrons will move and more kinetic energy will be gained. That means kinetic energy is directly proportional to the frequency. And another point, kinetic energy is independent of intensity of light. Until and unless threshold frequency is applied, electrons will not be ejected. No matter how intense the light that falls on the metal surface, the minimum frequency is required to eject the electrons. And this is the graph. If we plot graph between the kinetic energy and the frequency, the graph comes like this, and this is the threshold frequency, nu zero. Threshold frequency is denoted as nu zero, and this is the graph between kinetic energy and intensity. So it is the straight line to x-axis.